In this lesson, we're going to configure Easy Titles to match the settings we'll be using throughout this course. Let's open Easy Titles. You'll notice that on Easy Titles, you always have to have an open project. So when you start the program, it'll create a new project for you and ask for the project settings. If you have a second monitor, it'll probably show a solid green color. By default, Easy Titles designates the second monitor as a preview monitor. That is, it shows you exactly what the subtitles will look like in the final video. In addition to the project settings, we also see the preview window, which shows us a visual representation of the project subtitles. The preview window can be toggled by clicking on the preview checkbox. For the time being, let's just click OK and open a default project. The next dialog box is File Details, where you can add information about the project to help organize your work. You can uncheck Show this dialog on startup if you don't want to see it anymore. We're going to change a few settings. Some of them are mandatory, in the sense that you're going to need them for this tutorial. The others are optional. They're just suggestions that don't affect your enjoyment of this course. First of all, let's go to Edit, Preferences. The following settings are mandatory for this course. Under Performance, we'll set Default Video Start Time Codes to all zeros. This will be the start time code for most of the videos we'll be using. Under Editing, we'll check Auto Renumber. This guarantees that the subtitle numbers will always be updated when we remove or insert subtitles. Still under Editing, let's check Preview Mode Only. Easy Titles has two basic modes of operation: Edit Mode, where you can select subtitles without affecting the video position, and Preview Mode, where the selected subtitle always matches the video position. For this course, we'll be using only Preview Mode, so let's keep it as the default option. Under Cues, we'll check the option Jump to Next Subtitle on Set Out Cue. As the name suggests, whenever you set an out cue, Easy Titles will automatically select the next subtitle, creating a new subtitle if necessary. Now for the optional settings. Under Performance, Second Monitor Preview is activated by default. If you have a second monitor and want to use it for something else, we recommend you turn this option off. Let's go to Shot Changes. Whenever you open a video file, Easy Titles analyzes that video for its audio waveform and shot changes. This information is usually stored in auxiliary files, which are kept by default in the same folder as the video. If you want Easy Titles to keep all the auxiliary files in the same folder, you can designate it here. This makes it easier to delete the files later on. And that's it! Easy Titles is installed and ready for our course. In the next lesson, we'll explore the program's powerful interface. See you there!